Hello and happy Saturday, my beautiful internet friends. I'm still rocking like the no makeup thing. I have like lip gloss on, but just been really tired of makeup lately. I don't know, I'm just done with it for now. Yeah, anyways, today we're gonna be talking about why I quit smoking. Now, when I tell people I used to smoke, they're usually perplexed. I guess I don't strike people as a smoker or an ex-smoker, which honestly makes sense. A lot of things about my lifestyle don't really point in the direction that I ever would have smoked, but I did. I smoked really heavily for about 11 months. And by heavily, I mean I went from never having a cigarette in my life to smoking almost a pack a day, probably a half a pack a day on any given day, a little bit more sometimes. And honestly, I had no intention of ever slowing down or stopping because I really enjoyed it for a variety of reasons, which we'll get into. And why I started was important. But then something happened, something changed, and I knew that I had to make a change, but that change was not easy to make. This is not an anti-smoking PSA, but in some ways it is. Please know that if you're a smoker, I get it, I've been there, and I'm not telling you you suck or you should, you know, stop right now, because I know the struggle and I get it, but I also knew that for my health and for other reasons, which we're about to talk about, I just couldn't do it anymore, and this is just my story. So, as many of you guys know, I was in a pretty bad place a few years ago. Back in 2011, I went through some pretty rough stuff. I was raped, I was in a super abusive relationship, I was in a church that was a very bad situation to be in, and then essentially I lost my entire support system when everything that I had been going through came to light. I didn't lose my entire support system, but everything changed, and I was barely hanging on. When you go through something like that, you're a different person. At least that's what I felt like. And the way that I coped, all things considered, honestly, I don't think was the worst thing in the world, was I started smoking, like all the time, heavily. And I would hop in my car, I'd crack the driver's side window a little bit, and I would drive and listen to music and try to get away from that sinking, impending feeling of I don't want to be alive anymore. And I did that for months, and I'd sit on my back porch and I'd smoke, and I'd sit on my roof and I'd smoke, and I'd journal and I'd smoke. One thing that was really helpful about it and the hardest thing to stop is that a couple of the friends that I had at that time were smokers, and some of the best conversations we had were sharing a cigarette. And God, this is uncomfortable to talk about. I haven't talked about this stuff in a long time. Yeah, anyways, the funny thing is I was also really active. I was also really physically active and in shape at that point, and I felt it. Like, I freaking felt it. The impact it had on my body and my lungs. My cardio went from like here to like there quickly. And I'd also started training mixed martial arts at that time and was committed to it as much as I could be with the ankle situation I had. Walking into your gym smelling like smoke is not a great thing to do. And so I tried to like cover up with body spray, and I think I thought that I fooled people. I'm certain that I didn't. Cause like you can still smell smoke on people. I attempted to cover it up at least. I was intensely ashamed of it, but I also, it was like the only thing that I was holding on to. I drew kind of like an internal self portrait that I can't find. I've been looking for it, where I drew a picture of a girl like holding on to a cigarette over a ledge, and that was the only thing keeping her afloat from plunging to her death, because like I said, I really was extremely suicidal, extremely depressed, and didn't want to be on the planet. But smoking helped for like 2 seconds, even though it was really hurting me at the same time. And there are better ways to cope with things. That was what I chose to do. And it sucks you in. You know, I went from smoking like a cigarette or two a day to smoking way more than that. And the effects on my body, I noticed, but I didn't care about, because I didn't care a lot about myself at that point. Yeah, I felt that I was getting weaker. Yeah, I felt that it was affecting my cardio. Yeah, I knew that it was like slowly killing me, but also, if you don't care that much about yourself or being here, why would those things be super concerning to you? And they weren't to me. And then I met Brian. We met at a jiu-jitsu tournament that I was watching. He had come up with my gym. He was visiting from New York, and he made me laugh at a time in my life where I wasn't laughing, like ever. And we struck up a relationship and pretty quickly became boyfriend and girlfriend, dating. As I got to know him, he told me the story of how his father passed away, and it will always break my heart that I never got to meet his dad. His dad was a really cool guy, but his dad smoked super heavily, like really, really heavily his entire life. And his dad had 4 heart attacks before he passed away. And after every one of those, the doctors warned him so heavily against, you have to stop smoking, you have to stop it, and drinking. And his dad would get home from the hospital and just go straight for the cigarettes. And as my love for Brian quickly grew, and as I had, you know, that person in my life, I realized that me smoking was probably really messing with him. He never asked me to stop. he never was like, you need to quit doing that. Like, it hurts my feelings, or it reminds me of a bad time, or like, my dad died from that. What are you doing? But the connection is pretty clear. Like, he was very seriously dating someone who was a heavy smoker, and his dad had died from that. And I made the decision one night when I was kind of tipsy. I told him, I'm going to stop. I'm going to stop cold turkey. And then I woke up the next morning and was like, dear God, why did I tell him that? That was the worst thing ever. Like, I can't stop. I can't just quit. Like, what? Ugh. And then I did, because I said I would. And for 3 days, I felt like crap. Like, I had some serious withdrawals going on. But after 3 days, it was okay. And it was hard losing the community of, like, smoking and talking to friends. That was one of the hardest things. And it was really hard driving around listening to music in my car and not being able to smoke anymore. And I would love to say, like, I quit smoking and I never had another cigarette ever again. Yeah, but that's not the story. Anytime that Brian and I went through something really rough, or, you know, broke up for a couple days or whatever, I would immediately go to the gas station, buy a pack of cigarettes and smoke, and then stop again. And then I convinced myself briefly that, like, e-cigarettes were fine, and smoke those for a little while, and then realized that that's also just crap and an excuse, and stopped, and I haven't smoked in many years. And I miss it all the time. I hate saying that. I really hate saying that, but I miss it all the time. It was an enjoyable break from reality. It helped me cope during a time that was really rough, but it was also killing me. Kitties are making noises behind me. Anyway, the longer you smoke, the harder it is to quit. You still can, but it gets more difficult. And it was a way of getting through a really rough time. It wasn't the best way of getting through that time. It was a tool that I used. And I'm really glad that I stopped. I'm really glad that I don't smoke anymore. And I'm really glad that I was able to see that I was worth that. And if that's something that you're struggling with, believe me, I get it. Believe me, I understand how hard the draw is. I mean, nicotine's great, but it's also not great. So I'm not sitting here being all high and mighty, saying like, oh, if you're smoking, you should stop smoking, because it's really hard. And I get how nice it is, because I miss it all the time. But I can tell you from personal experience, it was 1,000% worth it to stop. And I found different ways of dealing with things. I journaled more. I really committed to athletics. I was way more active at my gym, as much as I could be, again, with the physical issues I was dealing with. I started drawing more and looked at healthier ways to cope. And that got me to a much better place than continuing to smoke would. I would never recommend starting. I would never recommend ever trying smoking to anybody, because it's hard to let go of, and it doesn't just leave you. Like, I haven't smoked in years, and I still think about it weekly, at least. So that's how I quit. I quit cold turkey. It took about 3 days to feel physically okay, but then I went back to it a couple times until I finally stopped. Thank you for listening to my story, guys. I would love to hear your stories. Again, there's zero judgment. I get it if this is something you do, something that you do want to stop or you don't want to stop. I get it. I get both sides of it. I really do. But what I can tell you is that my lack of motivation to stop smoking came from a place of not thinking that I was worth it, of not thinking my health was worth it, of not really wanting to stick around on the planet anyways. And I was able to work through those things and realize that I'm absolutely worth fighting for. My health is worth fighting for, and so is yours, whatever that looks like for you. And it's weird, I told you guys a lot of stuff, but telling you that I used to smoke is weirdly exposing for me. I don't know why. So especially thank you for listening to today's story. Let me know what you guys are thinking about Saturday story time, if I should keep it going. I like telling you guys stories that are just from different parts of my life, different times of my life, sometimes from a long time ago that feel very far away. I love you guys. I'm thinking about you. I will talk to you soon. Bye, guys. Hang in there. Hand her from the sky, holding by.